Hey, it's Hunt. You found Hunt on Saints. We're talking black and gold football. Do us a favor. Hit the like button, share your comments below, and hit that subscription button so you can get all of our content. Enjoy. Last week, the Saints made the signing of Equanimeous St. Brown official. He'll join the wide receiver crew and I think compete for a roster spot and a role on this team because he's got a skill set that's different than the rest of the crew that they've currently got assembled in New Orleans out wide. So we discussed that last week, but I thought a little bit of an interesting nugget over the weekend. Equanimeous St. Brown has chosen a number. He's going to wear number 13. And if memory serves, there was another receiver that was wearing number 13 for the last 5 years. Six, 7 years. And it struck me a little bit because there was a time there when he was setting NFL records that you figured Michael Thomas's number was destined to go into the rafters. Like, nobody wears number 8 for the Saints. That's Archie's. Nobody wears number 9. That one will go up for Drew Brees. And even Marcus Colston, after he finished his time, it was 4 years before someone wore his number. Like, 12 was off limits for a few years. And I think everyone realizes, like, I don't think anyone is going to suggest that Michael Thomas's number is going to be retired because the injuries just derailed the whole thing. And it really became more of like a 3-year blip than a sustained long career or a run. It was a fever dream. It was so fast. It was so awesome. And then it was over. So I'm not shocked that someone else is wearing 13, not in the least. But it's just another reminder of like how this thing went south. I would say quickly, but it wasn't even that quick. It just went so south between the Saints and Michael Thomas. And a career that we thought was going to be long and illustrious in New Orleans was not long. It was illustrious for a short bit. And then it was sour. And I'm curious if that's going to be repaired. My sincere guess is yes. Over time, Saints fans will overwhelmingly look back at Michael Thomas's time as a positive because of the greatness he displayed over a 3-year time where he was the best wide receiver, most productive wide receiver in the National Football League. And time heals the wound of what happened next, where he's MIA, and then they don't know what the injury is, and then he waits to have surgery, and then he comes back, and he's got to have surgery, and then he's on Twitter, and he's bashing the staff, and he doesn't like Dennis Allen, and he and Derek Carr don't get along, and then he's out the door, and he's bashing the staff on the way out, and saying that and he's all over Jeff Duncan's case, and like there was just so much there late that in the middle of it, you're like, God, would you just chill out? Would you just grow up a little bit? But I think when you look back, it'll be a positive memory. And I don't know if Michael Thomas comes back to honor Drew Brees. There's no Super Bowl that he's got to be a part of remembering over the years with reunions and whatnot. So maybe the relationship just kind of fizzles and it just doesn't exist anymore. But you know, when we talk about Michael Thomas, when I look on Twitter and see some of the reactions, like it feels like the majority of Saints fans are kind of put out with the way that it ended. And like, just go away. There are still some that stand solid behind Michael Thomas and they think the organization's to blame for some of this stuff and they stand by their guy who was maybe their favorite player at the time. But the majority, I think, is like, dude, enough. Will it be a number 13, a new one, this coming year? Equanimeous St. Brown will don that number and it will not go up in the rafters anytime soon. I don't think. Maybe I'm wrong, and if you think that his number, because of that incredible run and record-breaking success that he had in a short time, if that warrants getting your jersey retired, voice that opinion. I'm curious to see if there's anybody that thinks that, but I think that this marriage is dissolved. It's time for Equanimeous to come in and rock the number 13. Hey, it's Hunt. Thanks for watching Hunt on Saints. Before you leave, help us out a little bit. Hit that like button, leave your comments in the section below, and hit that subscribe button. So you get all our content right here from Hunt on Saints. We'll see you next time.